and you've got a friend in me.
Forgiven and free, yeah. Well, you and I. said yes. How many of you have seen or heard a love story match made by God? Raise your hand. Woo! A few years ago, during Karen's parents' 25th wedding anniversary, we heard Ate Lourdes and Kuya Leo's love story, a match made by God. I know most of you guys experience their love story, and we're about to hear Karen and Thomas's love story. How it all started. Who can tell me when Karen and Thomas met? Anybody know? Oh, I'm looking for a mom. Anyone?
December.
August.
Alan.
What is it?
Somebody yell?
September.
Yes. Woo! Awesome. Okay. I wish I had a prize for all of these good guesses, but God will reward you. How did they meet? Does anyone here, or can anyone guess how they met? A dating app. Do we know the dating app?
Christian Mingle.
Good guess. Not Christian Mingle. No, I'm glad she stayed away from Tinder. Christian like herself. Their conversation went well. Where do you think they first met? Where do you think they first met? Park? No. Church? No. They first met through FaceTime. Yes. So, how are we loving this love story so far? the test, Karen asked if they could meet through FaceTime first, and then they went and set up a park meeting. So that's the park that everyone's calling park, right? So Karen was ready to meet him in person, so Tómas suggested to meet at the park near her house to do a Bible study together. Karen was delighted and surprised that a young Christian would suggest doing a Bible study for a first date. Like, really, Tómas? Wow! Bible study for a first date. You see, you wonder why Karen is, you know, this blooming right now? That's why. She asked Tómas to bring his guitar so they would worship together at the park, since they both sing. Tómas picked up Karen and met Karen's mom. I call her Ate Lourdes. Karen's mom. Karen never went on a date with anyone before. So you know how special this is, right? The date went well, so Tómas invited Karen to the Zeal Young Adults Bible Study Worship and fellowship together went well. However, after that night, Karen thought that he was too young. So how many? Okay, here's the next question. How young do you think Tómas is from Karen? How many years is he younger than Karen? Five? Nope. Three, no? Four! You guys are right. Four. Okay. So, yeah, 4 years old. So,
4 years old.
I mean, four years younger, sorry. But you can tell, Karen does not look 4 years older. Look how gorgeous she is. Yeah. So Karen was looking for a forever man, and she was afraid that he was too young. So she said goodbye to him. Boo! Boo! And of course, Ate Lourdes was devastated. As she loved Tómas or Karen since their first meeting. Karen also met amazing friends from Zeal Bible Study at Court Church that she kept in touch with. You guys, yay, give yourself, applause. Okay, so, and she has become really good friends with a lot of you guys, and so, I wanna give Genesis and Emma right here the, you know, little accomplishment. Tómas again. What did you guys do to? According to this story, you guys were a big part of that, so we want to hear it. Okay. It was a dare. What did you dare her to do? Let's hear it. Okay. Go ahead. So you dared her to do something.
You dared her to invite him.
You dared her to invite him. Okay.
To message him.
Sorry. To message him. Awesome. So they dared Karen to message Tómas. And so Karen texted Tómas and say, hey. She just said, hey, on the text. Right? And of course, right? Is that what happened? And then, of course, Tómas.
He told me just text hey and see where God leads
you. Yeah, so.
That's great.
Yeah. That was a great dare, right? So they said just text hey and see where God leads you, right? And God led Tómas to reply right away. And their conversation went well, obviously. because he invited her to a Nutcracker show at UCLA, which Karen was very surprised and very excited because she's never been to see a Nutcracker live. And it was also her first time being asked out by a guy. You know, it's really not the first time, because she would have many opportunities to get asked out by a guy, but she just is not willing to entertain them, because I don't even know how many times I have given her, hey Karen, what do you think of this guy? Hey Karen, what do you think of this guy? You know, let's, you know, go hang out. But no, Karen was picky, and God had a different plan for Karen, and clearly here he is, right? So
So the day before, they watched Nutcracker together that Saturday, and the day before they attended the Zeal Bible Study together again for the Ugly Sweater Christmas Party event.
Yeah, so what do you have to say about that? Because you're like, yeah, yes, she's like your wingman, right? Okay, so after watching the Nutcracker together, Tómas took Karen that same night to the Grove, where coincidentally, his brother Alex and Daniel were also spending their night at, and Karen was surprised how Tómas introduced her to them and how very kind and welcoming they were towards her. Let's give Alex and Daniel a big hand of love right there.
Thank you, Karen, for so welcome. And it was the last night that Karen gave hints to Tómas, in which he picked up on and he asked her to be his girlfriend that night. December 18, 2021, Karen got her Christmas miracle, the gift of Tómas, her answered prayer. Tómas likewise to Karen is his gift from God, because he really prayed to meet a woman of God who would build him up and encourage him in his new born again life and walk as a recent follower of Christ. That same month, Karen's brother, Alwyn, invited Tómas to join them in their Christmas family day at Disneyland to congratulate them on their getting together. Tómas' mom flew here to LA from Essex, Connecticut in April of this year to visit and meet Karen as Tómas' girlfriend. And just last week, Tómas visited his hometown, Essex, Connecticut again, but this time bringing Karen along to meet his dad and family, and they proposed to and to propose to her, a love story written by God. Tómas and Karen born for each other. What are the odds of meeting of each other and our Lord Jesus Christ saving Tómas as a recent genuine Christian Christ follower in the exact time that Karen was ready to date, get married to an equally yoked man of God? What are the odds? It's God, right? Let's give him a big round of applause. Yeah, seriously, God could not have set a perfect man for Karen. Tómas is exactly the kind of person she's been praying for. So at this time, I would like to call on an inspiration talk here at WBC. He's also Karen's life coach and mentor. Let's give him a big round of applause.
Hello. Many years ago, in one of my devotions, I heard this thing, I read this thing, it says, good things happen to those who wait. Okay, let me repeat that. Good things happen to those who learn to trust and wait on the Lord. This is exactly your love story. You learn to trust and you learn to wait. You know, when Ate Lourdes called me, of course, the mom, said, my daughter is almost 30 and she doesn't even have a boyfriend. So she started to get worried. So she said, can we do a makeover? Cut it, short haircut, color, and makeover. And so that's what we were doing. We were having our sessions. And during those sessions, I got to know Karen more. And I also got to appreciate her more. Because I told her, it's a good thing that you waited. She just didn't date anyone. She waited for the right one. When she showed me Thomas' picture with the long hair, I said, Karen, are you sure this is a rock star? Are you sure about this? But you know what attracted Karen about Thomas's character? It was his humility. And when we went out, the three of us, we went out for a date. I was gonna tell them something, but they ended up telling me something instead. And Thomas ministered to me in a way that just on the side, I told Karen, this has to be the right person. Don't let this pass. But sure enough, I got to know Thomas in a different way. And I saw them, they were so in love, very much in love. And so it's not just the waiting, it's also the trusting. And when you trust, you have to be proactive. So when the mom said, let's do something, Karen obeyed. See, that's the thing. When you trust, you don't just trust blindly. You follow. You obey. So I see a lot of young people here, and I'm sure some of you are waiting for your lifetime partner. If it happened to Karen and Thomas, it can happen to you guys. Believe me. This is a pure product of prayer. Not just one-time prayer. Years of prayer. Yes. So you better start now. And when you trust, you also take time to listen. Listen when there's prompting from the Lord. And I always say, for you to find the right person, be the right person, right? That's why you don't mess up your life. You don't. The small things that you do that is right in the eyes of God, He takes you. God gives you credit for that. When nobody sees you, God does. And I'm so happy for their relationship because it's so pure, it's so simple. You should see them when they're just by themselves. They're like really young couple in love. I'm jealous. No. But truly, I really appreciate how they've opened their lives to all of us, inviting us here. Thank you for Ate Lourdes. Also, you have freelance. You should say thank you. No, but the truth of the matter, when we started, it hasn't been like, I think it was 6 months after before you showed up when we started preparing Karen. I felt like I'm Mordecai preparing my Esther. But it was really a journey, and when I saw the announcement, we were on a boat. My wife said, Karen is engaged, what? But the truth of the matter, I kind of had a feeling that you would be engaged when you went to Connecticut. Thomas would not pass this opportunity. Yes, because Thomas felt so blessed to have Karen in his life. That is one thing he told me. He told me in such a way that you could really and truly know that he was sincere about it. And so Thomas, you see all these people around here, you better not mess up. They will be so quick to jump on you. No, Karen is our little princess. We've known her since she was, middle school, high school. And I thought she was going to be 21 forever. But boy, we're so happy that you are gonna be starting your own life together with Tómas. The man in love. She's so in love too. She's blushing. No, it's blushing. So, my words for everyone, not just for a relationship, but anything that you're waiting, because in our lifetime, we will always wait. We're waiting in the drive-thru, we're waiting for our coffee in the Starbucks, we're waiting for our flight to leave, we're waiting for the ship to dock. We will always be waiting. But if you're waiting for that one person, and you for that particular person, I'm speaking especially for these young people here, occupy yourself with the Bible studies, with your reading, with your devotions, with your small groups. You know, develop your character, because God knows exactly what you need, and He will give it to you at the exact time. Isn't that what happened to you guys? And so I give glory to God for this relationship. Thank you and good afternoon.
Amen. Thank you.
I've been praying about it for some months, just trying to, I was saying, just to trust the Lord and wait on His timing and His leading. And I just made some plans, and I was just seeing if, you know, my steps were established. And I've made a plan to go back and introduce Karen to my family in Connecticut, show her where I grew up. And then I also had to get the engagement ring, so that was a big piece of the puzzle too. Didn't want to send that over in the mail or by bird or something. So we went, and I kind of had made a plan to take her to this lighthouse that I knew of in Rhode Island, and somebody had told me that she wanted to be proposed to at a lighthouse. And so that was everything that I intended to do. Then Sunday morning came, listening to Pastor Steve preach, those poor church family here. God spoke to me that morning and was saying that I should do it then. And that was the time. And so I brought her down to, this little it's like an alcove in my town, which is like a greenery with, some picnic benches and a little pond. And we were walking down the path, and I was telling her that Connecticut's filled with ticks, and we don't really have them out here, but you can get, ticks suck your blood and you can get sick from them. And so she was kind of having anxiety over that. And I was like, oh man, I just should have kept my mouth shut. I tell myself a lot that nowadays. But so I was like, okay, just forget about it. It's gonna be all right. We're on the path for 60 seconds. It's not like we're rolling around in the woods, I had done growing up and come out with 3 ticks on me. So we get down there, and she starts kind of filming it with her phone, the scenery, because she really enjoys, taking pictures and filming things so that she has the memories of, her experiences. And I'm not really like that, but I admire that about her. I just keep it up here. But it's good, because my mom breaks out photo albums sometimes, showing me of when I was a child, and I would never have been able to see that kind of stuff if somebody didn't take the time and care to do that.
Amen. That's
so
right.
That's Karen. So we get down there, she's filming, and then I go down on one knee, And she kind of turns around and she's really startled, actually. And I have a ring and I say, Karen Grace Simpson, will you marry me and continue to serve the Lord our God with me? And...
So, you know, in the love story, Annalisa told you guys that they were invited for the, what do you call it, the ugly sweater, the Christmas party for the youth. Okay, that night, I was praying that it will not be included in the, you know, in the story, because I don't have anything to say anymore. So I'm praying, and good enough, it was not included. Anyway, that night, actually, Tómas came to our house and asked parents' permission to go then to court. He invited her parents to go attend their, your Christmas, ugly sweater Christmas party. Okay. For the SEAL youth, and Bible study. Anyway, Tómas, when he came into our house, actually it's the second time he came to our house. The first time, I think he saw it already, you know. I was talking about way back 2014 when we bought the house, you know. We bought the house like November 2013. Then 2014, February, you know, it's my birthday. I told my husband, who's her late dad, I told him, hey, give me a gift for my birthday. And my husband said, what do you want? I said, you know, it's like this size of the wall of the house, because, you know, we just moved into that house. And I said, I wanna ask, you know, Noel Kasake, you know, it's our, also our church mate, and he's starting to do his, you know, his brilliant skill in photography, you know. So I said, I want to commission Noel Kasake to do, you know, the view in that, to hang in that wall, because it's so bare. You know, and in, you know, when you come into the living room, it's that wall you're gonna see right away. So I told my husband, I wanna make a good impression, you know. If only for that thing only, they will come into the house and they can see, you know, wow, they can just see a good wall, you know, a good picture hanging the wall. And I said that because, you know, we have to commission now, because if he's gonna be famous, you know, we cannot afford him anymore. Good enough, he's not here, unfortunately, because he's so famous that he has to go, you know, he's out now. I don't know where in the world he is now. He's touring around the world for photography, I don't know, like teaching new photographers, you know. Yeah, they're on tour, so that's how he's famous now. And so it's a good, you know, a good call for me. And so I gave him a pattern, you know, to do for the wall painting. But, you know, when it came, you know, it's like this. Do you know who can tell? This is the template. Alex, you're disqualified. Now you're disqualified, Alex. Even you then. Anyway, this is the template that he made for the wall. And he said, I said, what is that? That's not Morro Bay. You know, I asked him to do the Morro Bay because that's where, you know, I love that place where we did the camping, you know, the church camping, and it's our first time there. And I love the, you know, the mountain also. Especially like this, you know, I should have brought, he made me another painting, you know, just to, you know, so, you know, like pacify me. Anyway, I said, oh, okay. Atelurus, this has to be like this because you want, that space needs a panoramic view, like, you know, horizontal, to occupy a good space of the wall. And the Morro Bay painting that I gave him, you know, it won't do like that. You know, it's just a square. So it's still not gonna look look good on the wall. So it turned out this is Iceland. So when the first time Tómas came to our house, I thought he was looking at me, asking me permission. When he asked permission, of course he's looking at me, but I told him something like, okay, take care of my daughter, because you know it's the first time he's asked. I thought he's listening, but all the time he's looking at that wall, the painting. That was the first time. The second time, that was, you know, he came back again to our house, invited Karen, asked permission to meet. But when he came inside the house, he went right away to that wall, and he said, Karen, do you know this painting? Karen said, yeah, Iceland. You know, before when the painting, you know, I cannot do anymore. No, I'll finish it. So it's hanging the wall. And I said, everybody who come, ooh, that's a nice painting. Yeah, where is that? Everybody asked me, Iceland. Oh wow, Iceland. And then after 2 years, my son Alvin was able to go to Iceland, and then he bought a beanie, you know, and it says Iceland. And so I got that beanie, I told him, don't wear it anymore, give it to me, and I, you know, nailed it to the wall so that it would say Iceland. So now everybody who's coming in the house, wow, it's Iceland. And I said, okay, now it saved me, you know, where is it? Okay. I didn't know. I pray everything about what I like to buy, or I pray, you know. Sometimes I don't buy at all, I just pray. You know, but that one I pray for it. And so God, I pray for it. Why is it that Noel, you know, gonna give me like that Iceland? I don't know what also your reason, because I believe Romans 8:28, you know, in everything, you know, it will work out for your good. It might be a mistake, whatever, but if you're a child of God, in Romans 8:28 says, in everything, he'll fix it, he'll work it out. So I keep on, years pass by, you know, I'm really puzzled about that painting. Why in the world, you know, for what many, you know, that he can do, why is it that Noah has to pick him up? Iceland, you know? Okay, then when they met, and Tómas said, oh, do you know Karen, this is Iceland? And Karen said, yeah, there, you know, the beanie, Iceland. And he told his story that his mom is from Iceland. Oh. And so I said, oh God, so that's the reason. So now, every time I look at that wall, I love it now. And I appreciate it so much. And I keep on praying for Noel. I keep on praying for Noel everywhere he goes. Noel, I am so sweet to him already, you know, because, you know, I think the Lord God ministered to him to pick up this. You know, this is the template that he made, so he wanted me to choose which one, you know, the glossy or this one, the glossy one or this one, you know. So anyway, this is the template I brought, because I cannot, you know, I love the pictures. Anyway, I believe that, you know, the Lord Jesus Christ as a forerunner, remember John the Baptist, to clear his path. I think that painting, I told Noel, oh Noel, I love you for doing that painting. And I said, oh, that painting is a forerunner from God, which is to clear the path for the two of them. They say that it's a love story made from heaven. Yeah. And Noel Kasahel, you know, since 2014, was the minister from our God. Thank you for this. Anyway, Tómas too was so excited when you know, he FaceTimed his mom and told, you know, about the painting, you know, and the mom was really thrilled about the whole story. And now I'm so glad. That's Abel, isn't it?
No,
oh no, I thought that's your pastor. You're the pastor. The book's prayer. Save me from, you know, from the benefits of.
Welcome, guys. Come on.
Hector and Grace. Okay. Then I think in a little while the pastor will be coming. But it's my time now, so I guess I'll finish my cue, you know. My life. Okay, now, you know, added to the love story now, I'm going to do the benediction for the body then. I always do this. I love doing this. Because I believe whenever I say, you know, to my children, it really, really, the Lord really, really is, how do you call it, true to his promises, you know, with this this blessing of benediction, okay? So let's bow our head and now give them, you know, the benediction. May the Lord our God bless and keep you. May he preserve you always, Lord. And dear God, may your face shine upon them and be gracious to both of them, to Karen and Tómas for their newfound journey in their life. And I pray, dear God, that you will lift up your countenance to both of them and grant them peace. Peace that passes all understanding. Peace that provide, peace that protect, peace that heals, peace free from any worry, fear, anxiety, and most of all, Lord, free from any, you know, wavering faith and doubt. So I pray also for all your goodness and mercy, but it's also your promise, Lord, that goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. And that's also my prayer to both of them, to both from now on, Lord. Goodness and mercy shall follow them all the days of their life. And thank you for your kindness, for your goodness, for your favor to both of them. And thank you, Lord Jesus, for everything. This we pray in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen. Thank you.
Hi everybody, I just wanted to say definitely so happy for these two and their journey. I know that they've been really wanting this for such a long time, and we're so happy to have Karen part of our family, and I know that my parents feel the same way having her out visited, and just so happy for both of them, and just want the Lord and goodness to surround them and to make sure that their journey is kind of safe and protected. So really, really happy for both of them, and just there's lots of greatness to come.
Who took their time to come here and celebrate with us. It's just so grateful for each and every one of you. You guys are, you know, my home church, Wilshire Baptist Church, and then Tómas home church, Core Church LA, which is also my church now. It's just we're all one big happy family, and I'm just so grateful that, you know, each and every one of you God placed in our lives with the exact, you know, timing. And just thank you for always, you know, encouraging us and for all the fellowship and just the love. It's just so overwhelming, you know. It's like my whole church is like a community raising me. So this is the product of all their prayers. All those years, I'm so grateful. You know, you guys are, that we have a family. You guys, ever since my family, you know, came to this church, and that was like 19 years ago. So I came in this church when I was 10 years old. So ever since then, everyone's been like a family to me. I'm just so grateful. And to feel that same like family love from, you know, Tómas' home church, Core Church LA, I'm just, God is so amazing. You know, if you just, you put your trust in him, and you just, I can't like fathom like how he works. He's just so sovereign, and just so grateful for all the love, and, you know, just so grateful. Thank you for everyone.
Thank you, guys.
Amen. Too many billion people running around the planet. What is the chance in heaven that you'd find your way to me? It's a miracle that's happened. Though I search for an explanation, only one thing it could be. I was born for you.
Christian!
Thank you.
Oh wow, I've heard this song.